I just want to thank our guys for being here. Curtis Aiken, Sam Clancy, Julius Page, and Kirk Bruce. I just want to get that out because they're probably the reason why we are here, because of what they've done over the years. But getting back to that, obviously, it was something that very, very, I hope to be very reminiscent. It was a great atmosphere. I think it brought the city out. I think this will be somewhat different, obviously, when you have two Pittsburgh teams, two local teams that have had great tradition in playing in this arena. So, yeah, it was a great atmosphere, and I think any time you have an arena that's meant so much to people, I think it should go out in the right way. And I think both Duquesne and University of Pittsburgh realize that and did the things necessary to bring this about. So I can't thank both Steve and Greg for, I think, doing the right thing and doing the classy thing and doing the best thing for the city of Pittsburgh.
Ron, you have some history of watching games here. Give us an idea of what it'll be like coaching games.
Yeah, you know, for me, it's a real honor and pleasure to be sitting here and having the ability to be a part of a game like this. When I was a kid, I watched Sam and JD and Nels play up here, and that's what college basketball was all about to me as a young kid. And the Eastern Eight was the only real college basketball that I knew. And to have the ability to come back into a situation like this where two local teams are going to have an opportunity to come and compete in that type of environment, I think is great for us. Obviously, we have a rebuilding program. I think Jamie and Pitt's success as a basketball program has helped us tremendously in terms of making young people understand what a great option it is to play in this town. I think this will go a lot further in terms of furthering that notion with the younger guys. And our team has, over the past couple of years, have played in some really tough environments at Boston College a couple of years ago, last year at Duke, in our A-10 championship game against Temple, which was most certainly their home game, and at Virginia Tech in the NIT. And I think that those challenges have certainly helped our basketball program grow. I know that I embraced the opportunity to play in another environment like that here at Mellon Arena in the last college basketball game played here, especially against such a great program as Pitt has right now. And I think that from that perspective, our kids have been very excited about playing a game like this here. I know from a coaching perspective, I'm very excited about playing a game like this here, and I think it's going to be a great opportunity for our program at Duquesne University.
Ron, did you think twice at all about giving up the intensity of Palumbo for this, your home game?
Not really. I mean, I think that, again, to me, this is what college basketball is all about. This is where Duquesne used to play every game. And, from that standpoint, I was very excited to have as young a team as we have face the type of challenge that it would be to play in the Civic, well, actually I got to say Mellon Arena now, and have the type of crowd and the type of hostile environment that it's going to be. I just think it does wonders for our program. It'll be great for our kids, and they specifically, those guys want to do that. I mean, that's something that they're very excited about.
Jamie, has Duquesne's increased success added to the competitive fire of this game, knowing where it was early part of your career when you first came here?
It always has been. I mean, from the beginning, and I didn't understand it coming here 11 years ago, but I figured it out very quickly. And there's just, the kids playing against each other in the summer, the schools, the familiarity they have with one another, and then the history, the tradition of the game. All those come together and make it a different event. I mean, there's no question, especially for the fans, maybe not so much for the coaches, but also with the players, too. I think the players, fans really get it. I think coaches, we try to stay level-headed. We're going to say we're going to stay level-headed for every game, but I definitely think the players and fans, it's a different level of intensity. There's obviously different things that go into a game when you're so familiar with people that you're playing against.
Does it help that they play in summer leagues
together? I think it's good. I don't know. I think it's good for basketball. That's why we've done the summer league. So I think it's good, and good is helps, good helps. So I think that's why we do it. So I think it's great. I mean, people have asked us, you know, this game is something that we want to do. I mean, year after year. I mean, it's the right thing to do, and it's the right thing for the city, and that's why we're here as a university, to do the best things for the city, and that's why we play this game, and this is a good thing for everybody involved. So I don't see any. There is no bad.
Greg or Steve, please. Is there any indication when you might consider continuing this game at the new arena? Are there talks underway for that, or might that be something that you would decide soon, or when the new arena is ready?
I believe we've really tried to get through this game and get the parameters of the final game in Mellon Arena squared away. It's something we would consider conversations on. But I think we're at the last year of our most recent four-year partnership, so we're getting ready to sit down and talk about the future, and I think that's when we'll take the time to do that.
Jay, you or the athletic directors, could you maybe explain how the idea actually started and who came up with it and who approached you as the one to do this? It's their own game.
You want me to take that? I've been a college basketball fan since I've been born, and so getting this game here was something I wanted to do for a couple of years now, as soon as we knew that there was an end in sight. And so I spoke to Greg about it a couple times as we were having discussions about other possible events like the A-10 and the NCAA tournament bid, as well as approached Steve's staff at Pitt, and I was not sure I was going to get anywhere with it, but it took a little arm twisting over on this side, and I have to say I was the culprit, yes.
Greg or Steve or Dave, are there any other plans around the game, throwback type things, any being that is the final game, former players coming back, being honored, anything at this point that's works, or?
Those are all elements that we've discussed, and I think we'll, now that again we've got everything in place, we'll go ahead and look at collateral elements around the game. As we've said before, really this is a celebration not only of the many years that Mellon Arena has been in existence, but it's a celebration of this rivalry. So I believe we've got a unique opportunity to bring former players back and people associated with that rivalry from both Pitt and Duquesne, and make it a special evening all the way around.
Ron and Jamie, how important do you think it is, the Duquesne-Pitt relationship and rivalry? You both have conference commitments, but do you think that there's something to be gained from this city game that will benefit both of the programs?
I definitely do. I mean, it's why we play it. So, I mean, we've made that decision, and I think it's the best thing for the city, as I mentioned earlier, and the best thing for basketball in the city. So, and the best thing for the universities. I think to be on national TV, both universities being on national TV, is a great thing. And however that comes about, wherever we play it, I think it's all in all. I mean, at the end of the day, you have to do what's right, and I think this is the right thing to do. And we truly believe that, and I want them to be successful. I want Duquesne. I've said that after every game. Nobody believes me, but I do. Every time we play them, I do. And I want Robert Morris to be successful too. I don't want them to beat us, but I want them to be successful. And I think it's good for basketball. They're friends. I have great respect for the university, for Duquesne, and I can't tell you enough how good I think this is going to be for the city, and I think it's something we can build off of as well. So,
Albie, I feel the same way. I think it's great for us at Duquesne, you know, having the opportunity to play against such a great program as Pitt, the job that Jamie's done, and having the ability to do that right here in the same town, I think is kind of unique. And having the ability to play that game in an arena with such tradition is, like I said before, it's just a great thing for our basketball program, especially in the situation that we're in right now. So I couldn't be any more excited, and want to thank Jay and Steve and Jamie and, of course, Mr. Amodio here for putting this thing together, because I just think it's a great thing for our basketball program and the long-term growth of our basketball program.
Jay, you said you were the mastermind behind this idea to favorite city game moment that sticks out in your head?
I was at the game a couple years ago at Palumbo Center where the Duquesne had a furious comeback and it was a nail biter down to the end, and that's the one that sticks in my mind most recently because it was unbelievable atmosphere and hopefully it comes down to a last second shot by one of these teams this year as well.
That's his idea. The last second shot.
Yeah, probably neither of these groups think want that. But
no, I would say one other thing that this is Duquesne's home game. And the University of Pittsburgh is very appreciative of the fact that they were willing to move the game here. They were the ones that had to make this happen, and so we're grateful to Greg and Ron and their staff for letting this happen because it is significant but it wasn't our decision, it was their decision, and we're grateful that they were willing to do that.